Now, many people think, yes, only think, water is made of hydrogen and oxygen, and they'll use the electrolytic method to collect hydrogen and oxygen gas from water. So essentially, during a typical electrolytic process, a small voltage is passed through water and an electrolyte, and gases are produced at each electrode. However, in this video, we're going to alter your perception by not extracting hydrogen from water, but by extracting hydrogen from metal using the very same process.
You can be very intelligent and very good at what you do, and you can still be stupid.
Hi there, I'm Pete from Peter and Pete. Now, it's often stated hydrogen is the most abundant element in the universe, and it can even be found in water. However, we're of the opinion water doesn't contain any hydrogen at all, and hydrogen can be found in materials like metals. So to put this view to the test, we're going to see whether we can use water to extract hydrogen from aluminium metal. The main equipment we'll be using is a large plastic bowl, two pieces of aluminium rod, a 30 volt DC power supply, two copper wires, plus also two wires with crocodile clips, two test tubes and a makeshift test tube holder, water from the tap, silicon sealant, and a lighter and wooden splint. So the first thing to do is drill two holes in the base of the plastic bowl about 30 centimeters apart from the centers. Slide in the two pieces of aluminium rod and use silicon sealant to seal the metal rod in position. Next, the bowl is placed on a cardboard box and the wires from the metal rods are connected to a power supply using crocodile clips. Once the silicon sealant has cured, fill the bowl with water from the tap to a level that submerges the aluminium rods at least an inch. Fill both test tubes with water and invert them. Please ensure you avoid any air entering the test tubes at this stage. Slide the test tubes into the makeshift holder and wrap elastic bands around each test tube to hold them into position over each electrode. Once everything is okay, switch on the power supply and watch the bubbles of gas rise. We used 30 volts and generated far more gas at the cathode than the anode. So after we had garnered a test tube full of the gas at the cathode, we tested it to see what it was. Remember, a test tube full of hydrogen will always produce a squeaky pop when a flame is introduced into it. So let's see what we got. Well, from that squeaky pop, we certainly had produced hydrogen at the cathode. We left the electrolysis running overnight to fill the test tube held over the anode. By next morning, we had collected enough gas from the anode, so we're ready to test again to see what we got. Now, according to mainstream science, we should split water and produce oxygen at the anode. The introduction of a lit splint into a test tube filled with oxygen will make the flame glow brighter. But if we produce hydrogen at the anode, again we should get a squeaky pop when a lit splint is introduced into the test tube. So will the gas be oxygen or hydrogen? Let's find out. Well, it's very clear that was indeed hydrogen that we had produced at the anode. That's very unusual and certainly unexpected. We had produced hydrogen at both electrodes, the anode as well as the cathode. But according to mainstream chemistry, we should never get hydrogen at both electrodes. So this result dispels the common understanding that water can be split into oxygen and hydrogen using electrolysis. And it also dispels the understanding that water is made of hydrogen and oxygen, H2O. It seems the aluminium was being decomposed by the water with the assistance of the electricity. It's easy to conclude this when you also take into account the white foamy substance that was produced by the process. Surely this white stuff floating in the water came from the aluminium. This reaffirms our understanding any hydrogen produced from the electrolysis process originates from the aluminium metal electrodes, and not any water. Yet some of you science people might disagree with our evaluation and think the oxygen from the water combined with the aluminium to form aluminium oxide. And as everybody should know from their science classes, aluminium naturally forms a thin protective surface layer of aluminium oxide on contact with oxygen. This layer is called a passivation layer. But if there is oxygen in water and it combined with the aluminium to form a passivation layer, that layer would have protected the aluminium from decomposition and the white stuff would not have been prevalent in the water. So there you have it. Hydrogen gas from aluminium metal using the electrolytic process. But let us know what you think. Let us know whether you think hydrogen originates from the aluminium or whether hydrogen originates from the water. And if you think a passivation layer of aluminium oxide was formed on the electrodes, why do you think the white stuff was accumulating in the water? Oh, and just one more thing. If you think we've fudged the demonstration, then feel free to perform the demonstration yourself. But always remember to test the gas products and be sure to let us know how you get on. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. And until next time, remember to like and subscribe and click that notification bell icon so you get notified when new content is uploaded. Well, thanks again, and I'll see you next time. Bye.
The Earth isn't round, it's flat.
How do you know?
I've observed it in all my travels over Europe. It's flat. Everywhere it's flat.